Welcome back to Amber Moon Blind, and welcome to the 200th episode. Wow, guys, on Morag, and we're at the Temple of Sorrel. I think we're almost done exploring it. I think we just have one room left to go to. And before I do anything, especially move into the shadow of the building, where those lizards seem to hang out. Let's get our protections on. Every little bit helps. Okay. Yep, right into it. See that? And if you stand there, they'll just repeatedly attack you. Windhowler. Now this one back here might sit back and throw range spells at us. Yeah, they're lizards, but they cast spells. Go figure. I don't see who else can use that dart. Because we got another Morag dart. At least that one just moved. Rinse, repeat. Small healing for, I guess, Nelvin. Lined up, I like that. That's Edgel can start hitting it. And I can break out the thunderbolts. Yeah, heal self. Oh, I forget to have Nelvin do his thing. No, he's just gonna stand there. So yeah, as you guys probably know, it's an extra long episode. 200th. I want to go to that village, so we'll be trying to go there this episode after we finish this. First we have to get inside the palace. Lame spell. Then we have to defeat what's in the palace, and we have to leave the palace, which might be another battle. Nelvin's been lamed. He's lames. Lameness. Remove the lameness. I think he can't attack, but I think he can still cast spells. I'm gonna cast it for everybody. Oh! Axe is broken. I saw that. Sorry guys, we don't play like that. We do not deal with broken weapons. Man. Alright, he's at 102. He's gonna be the lowest. Yeah. Alright, heal him. 102 out of what? Oh, yeah, I should be fine with a small heal. Kill these stinking things. Oh, that didn't even heal him all the way. Madness spell. No, I've been deflected. Yeah, I want him all the way healed, so. You know, try not to do that every time, but if a weapon breaks, I'm gonna be reloading it. Drug spell, Nelvin deflected. I'm trying all kinds of things on Nelvin. Melvin deflected madness as well. Anyone he have? He's just casting it just on him, right? Yeah, we're fine. Alright, I'm giving Sabine a medium healing. Windhowler over here. Gotta resist. Saving. Okay, she's good now. That was a good hit. Look at that. 26, 29. Melvin deflected the lame spell. I'm throwing a thunderbolt. Boom. Begin attack. And who should we heal? Back row is good. It's a train, maybe? Yay! I'm liking Windhower lately. I 17, that's better. And 14, that's good. It was going for Edgel. Edgel moved. Uh-huh. Where's the Wind Helen? Healed. Yeah, completely healed. We deflected that, I guess. Healing. I'm moving all right. Yay. All right, in. Four more come. Okay. All right. Saving. Episodes, wow. We're getting kinda near the end. Just to finish these palaces. And then I think we use the harp to melt the ice, or break the ice, rather. And maybe that's the final battle. If you guys know, don't say anything. No spoilers, please. Alright, we got the standard four here. Just a little Windhaler right there until they're set up. Oh, actually, let's cast a sleep spell on this one. Actually, can we? I think they sleep for longer if you're not hitting them. So let's cast a sleep spell on this guy on the left. And we'll just ignore him. We'll attack these guys. I didn't mean to do that. Go down. Sleep spell worked. Ugh. Really? Why every time with Edgel? I hate that. I think there's program to give you that right away, that critical hit. It's usually in the first couple rounds. And after that, it calms down a little bit. What's Wake the Dead? She has a robe with Wake the Dead. You're in the wrong place to use this item. We can't do it. We have to be in camp mode. Okay then. Alright, so let's try to put this guy to sleep as well. Actually, him. So he doesn't advance and start hitting Selena and or Sabine. And I don't want to do a save state with the person dead. Okay, it worked. At least for now. Critical hit. Yeah, Citrine is dead. Alright. Sorry, guys. This is what I'm doing. I try not to use the save states. I was only using them ever. Deflected, so he's not asleep. The only time I ever did that was when a weapon broke. But now I'm doing it when two members die, because it just happens so often with these magical guards. Give us something else to fight. So many of them. Repeat battles. Alright, I'm gonna try again with this. Sleep on this guy here. Critical hits are a little overpowered. Opinion. It does make them more challenging, but it's just... It should be like it does 200 points of damage, so then you struggle to keep them above that amount. You know what I'm saying? But it doesn't matter. They could be at full strength and be hit by a critical hit, so it's... He's deflected again. Just a sad state of affairs. Now we get all these hits because I wasn't able to put any of them to sleep. Hopefully this round coming up, I'll be able to put one of them to sleep. Critical hit, Citrine. We'll try to do it without her. If someone else gets hit, I'm reloading with the save state. We will do this sooner or later. Alright. You need a big healing. How is Valden? He's fine. Okay. Medium healing. Edgel? Nelvin? Let's put this guy to sleep. Try him again, this one. Boop. Deflected. I can't put him to sleep. Yeah, no. Loading! If the boss battle, that's one thing. It's just these guys over and over again. Let's see if the sleep spell will work this time. It did. Alright, guy in the top left is asleep. Stop hitting Agile, you're out of turns. Alright, let's also put this one to sleep. Lock that in. Okay, the two middle ones are asleep. Okay, 336, 286, all right. Medium healing. Let's do a sleep here. I wonder if there's ever a critical hit. Yeah, it did happen once. A critical hit didn't kill Citrine. But she had, like, something, like, in the teens points left. Alright, that was asleep too. There's, like, a chance. I think there's a chance for him to wake up. This is how we deal with it, just put all to sleep. Nice! Killed him in his sleep. It didn't work on him? I don't think it did. Oh, maybe it did. Not attacking. Maybe we'll keep this one asleep. Hit this guy for a little bit. Oh no, wait. Monster up. And you're moving over? Okay. 336. Small heal, she'll get him before he moves. Let Melvin defend this round. Reveal your hit points. Oh, I still had her with the arrow on the other guy. Oh, I woke him up. This guy stayed asleep, though. 18. just in case, have her as well. Oops. Meant to hit okay. Wait, I thought. Okay, we got him. That was me attacking Citrine. Okay, never mind. Not done with you yet. Okay, now we're done with you. Almost dead. Poof. I'm not sure, but it seems like they'll just wait forever until you start hitting them and then they have a chance to wake up. So I'm gonna wait till we're all in position. Like that. Right up your buttocks. Still sleeping. We might finish him off this round. Pretty good so far. Better. That's good. Ah, yes. 666. Selena, level 39 with 238 life points, 160 training points. Nelvin, level 40 with 162 life points, 647 power points, 193 spell learning points, and 86 training points. And Valden, level 34 with 314 Life points, 209 power points, 76 spell learning points, and 177 training points. And immediately saving. There's more of those, like, stone pillars or whatever. I don't think there's anything with those. So I tried looking at one and interacting with it. Yeah, there's nothing. I think they're just decorative. The trap has been disarmed. The chest has been opened. We found Morag armor, a Morag shield, and a Morag sword. And no money. Oh wait. There's something around the corner here. Oh, nothing? If we had map functions, I'd be, like, mapping out the room by, like, walking into everywhere. Still trying to see if there's, like, anything there. Or secret walls, but we know what's on the other side of that one. Alright, so let's see what this is like. So, the Swift Stabber is, for reference, it's a damage plus 32. It's a one-handed weapon. Who's got that sword? Plus 45. And it's also a one-handed weapon. Alright, you're getting this. Let me just see how it goes out. Hold on a second. 38. 54, nice. Very good. Let's have more of these Swift Stabbers. I can use it. I have been using it. Warrior. And we don't have Paladin or Thief, but we do have Ranger. Plus 25 on it. Wow. So maybe we should sacrifice his ranged ability and have him use that. And he'll let us take it off. Unfortunately, he's full. He's so full of stuff here. Full of crap, that's what he is. Alright, let's give him the Swift, one of the Swift Stabbers. So he loses his range, but his attack goes from 54 to... Oh, 38? Never mind then. Well, that's the Morag sword. I'm not even looking at Valden. Here's Valden. Alright. So... let me just see. I need room for this stuff here. Someone else take that. All these magical arrows. Okay. Take that back, because I want to see how it changes. Okay, so damage is 30. Damage now is 38. He loses his range capability, though. I think I'm going to just keep him with us, believe it or not. At least for now. It's really a help to not have to move him around the way he can reach people. He can hit anyone on the battlefield. It's awesome. Alright, so the Morag shield is a plus 15. Okay. That's 61. I have to wonder why this whole time. I guess I was wearing something that was... I was wielding something that was dual-handed, maybe, I mean, takes two hands to use. Like, maybe Fire Basher is like that. But yeah, we can use swords, I mean, shields with these. So his defense is 29, mine is 61. Without it, I'm 41, so maybe I should be giving that to him just to help him out a little. Okay. So if you find any other shields, definitely use them. Wield them. That's the harp. Alright. I don't have any other shields. Unless I look right at it and don't see it. Alright, so we also picked up... What did I pick up? I forget now. It was another Morak thing. Ugh. I forget already. Too many cool things. Oh, it was a Morak armor. I spelled Mithra wrong. Alright, so who's got the Morak armor? With sword, armor, and a shield. She has it. Alright, let me just look. Move this back. Alright, so this... 8,000 grams and it's a plus 20. Compared to the Mithril shirt. Which is a lot less grams, but it's a shield 15. Alright, so we should give it to Edgel. He can carry it. He has a slot, okay. Alright, let's see how this improves. Defense, 49. Now 55. That should make things easier. You hold that. I don't want him to have, like, no slots or anything. That's good. That helps. Definitely helps. Alright. Let's escape this place. I believe we are done with the Palace of Sorel. That's that one lizard we talked to, like, and then he died immediately after. Get out of here before the lizards come. Yay! Alright, so... I want to check out this village. The town. 22133. Alright, well it's gonna be this way. And then... Yeah. Stuff in our way. I'm trying to stay at 22. This must be it. Nice. And I think we were over here before too, and I was like, what is this place? But I'm like, nah, let's continue on to the other palace. The map works here. Why does the map work here in the town? Alright, what does that say on the map? Entrance? City gates. Cool. Do I have, like, floor textures off or something? No, it's not even available here. That's crazy. Did they not finish this town? I mean, you just got this plain, like, magenta floor here going on. Inn of the Flying Meranian. Alright, since we made it here, just going to save so I won't have to do it over again in case someone just unexpectedly kills us or something. Oh my. Now remember, we look like we're from Morag. Before you stands a Moranian, with a lot of gray spots on his skin. He notices you looking at him and says, yes, just look at my gray flecks. I was about to die of thirst several times already, and I am the last of my family. The others all died horrible deaths. But what can we simple lizards do? The High Council has more than enough water. I have heard that the palace of the highest counselor is even surrounded by a huge deep moat, but if anyone dares drink from it, he has them put to death. God. Guess that's all he said, yeah. That's a wall. Okay. Oh, hello. A large Meranian woman complains to you, we will all die of thirst if something doesn't happen soon. For years they have been promising we will soon have tons of water, and what happens? A drought, as ever. I cannot stand it any longer. Then sit down. Dump this guy over here. Before you stands a young, talkative Meranian. Actually, he says the least out of all of them. Hello, my name is Serep. I look after my mother's riding lizards. Oh, cool. If you need a good riding lizard, please come to our tower. It is located at 78136. Okay. I'm guessing that's outside of town then. I gotta write stuff down. Hold on 1 second. This is... yeah, here's my little Amber Moon notebook type thing. Tower with lizards. What's his name? S-Rep? He's a representative. Representative! All right, 78... 136. Okay, cool. Funny thing is, he's really not that talkative compared to the others. I don't know what that is. I'm just looking at it in case it holds something. Alright, there's stairs over there. And there's this. I don't know what that is. Now they move around, so... that's that one. I just want to make sure I don't miss one in case there's really four in here. think that's it. All the ones in here, okay. What brings you to my fine inn? 300 gold. Sleep outside instead, unless we start running low and we want to conserve on stuff. Rations. Alright, that's this inn. We're done with this. We are done with eat! Alright, let's check out this way. It moves faster without the floor textures. There are none. That's just funny how you can still map the town. I mean, I shouldn't complain. Is this the building that's the inn? I'm guessing it's the tavern. So wait. Oh. The entrance is over this way? Ah, I see. Smithy and Repair Workshop. Welcome! Do you want me to repair something? No. Don't need anything repaired. What does it say? Blacksmith of who? Blacksmith of Shangri-La. Shangri-La. Huh. I guess this says the same thing. Anyone walking around in this town? I don't see anyone around. What is this place? Prison. Enter only with permission from the authorities or if instructed by the court. Alright, maybe we'll save that for last. In case we can get permission from authorities. Well, it could be the case of how this game almost didn't come to be. Could be that they just never got far enough to make the floor textures here. Food proprietor Sutter. Or Sutter. Welcome. Do you want some tasty food to sustain you on your quests? One food ration will cost you 40 gold pieces. Wow. Pretty expensive. We're not rushing to get that one. Mixed goods proprietor. Smix. Mixed goods, okay. Merchant. Foodstuffs. Incredible bargains, yeah. Locator device. Do we want that? I think we already have that, right? Isn't that the same as a compass? Okay, we got tridents for 4,000. Healing potion 4, spell points 5. Strength potion, we got different potions. But I don't think we can increase anymore. Oh, it's the Morag dart I want to look at. In our inventory. There's more Morag robes. There's a Morag water bottle. Who's got the highest charisma? I think that matters, right? 100. I do. Okay, I have a feeling we're gonna need this. Morag water bottle. Special item. It's gotta be the same as the... It's gotta be the thing that puts your... here, or probably that gives you the coordinates. Imagine coming here and not having that. Oh man. You wouldn't be able to find these places out here. Wow, 43 spell points for... Let's use some more healing. See, I don't think I'm gonna need some of these spells. Wait a second. Yeah, he has a room for stuff. Alright. Let me just look at something. Who's got the Morag dart? I think it just looks like an arrow. Yeah. Alright, let's look at this. So it's a damage of 30. Mages can use it. Damages. Wow. Okay. This will help. Of course, he's not the best one to be equipping with that. Let's see Farron's crossbow. Damage is 30 here as well. Okay. So she's good with that. So wait, his is... 25. Okay, so if I want to keep him with long-range capability, I can give him that needle, and it's still going to do 5 more than he was. Sounds good to me. Okay, so damage going from 25, well, currently, without the buffs, to 30. This is my magical attack. Oh, is that a better version of magical assault? It could be. Alright, so Sabine already has the Morag Dart. So maybe one for Nelvin? I mean, he's gonna miss all the time with it. The Morag Sword does a lot more damage than the Dart. The Swift Stabber does a little bit more damage than the Dart. So should I buy one more Dart for Nelvin? $5,000. Right, so Nelvin going from attack 10 to 30. So maybe I'll sell these sickles then. Probably have a bunch of them. Not a hell of a lot, but it's gonna help us have, you know, space and inventory. I want to sell stacks of items so I don't use up his inventory slots. The only game I've ever seen that has an issue like that. I guess as far as... What do I do? If I sell all the magical arrows, because I don't need them now, right? 891. The crossbow doesn't use arrows, for sure. Here's another sickle. See how many slots he has open. There's two more. I want to leave the other one open. Because once you fill that, you can't give him anything else. I like to keep my options open. Mithril shirt. Does any of us have a mithril shirt we want to sell? Or a mithril shirt? Because he already has some. He can just stack it with what he has. He has the Morag armor. Okay, so he has one. Mithril shirt. Boom, that's a lot of money. I think I looked and she didn't have one. Yeah. Might be another one of us that has one. Yep. Boom. Now we're gonna start getting overweight with money, though. Okay. So we have a lot of money now. No. Healing potions? Lightning boots. Who has the Morag robe? She does. He has one as well. But I think... Wait. Right. Healer. And mage. Alchemist. So here's our healer. Here's our mage. And I'm an adventurer, not an alchemist, so I can't use the mithril. I mean, more aggro. So that's it for that. Other than that, get some more healing potions I got. Guess. Trying to use up some of this gold. Wow. Here we go. Alright, now... What else can I sell him? Two more things. Or stacks of things. All healing. Okay. Healing potion 3, 4, and all healing. And he's got spell points 5, they got 10 of those things. I'm probably just gonna be selling. How about all the ice balls? Spell points 2? Well, how'd that sneak in there? I didn't realize that was there. Kills undead things. Spell points 3. Okay, so spell points 2, 3, and 5. And spell points 5. And healing potion 4. You could definitely sell these ice spells. Let's try to get the maximum from them. Ice ball. No, I'm just gonna sell them like this. Let's keep a few of them. In case. Wow. And anything else? Ice storm. Now we have 14,000. More spell points, 5. Let's save this money. I don't know if we need to pay for these lizards. Hopefully it's not more than that. Oh, there's the proprietor. Okay. Yeah, I just went back here. Mapping out. Mapping everything. Is that a way out? Oh, looks back to a different part of town. Save that for last. Might be like to the palace or something. Alright, well, I've been here. Check out this really long building. Oh, I've been here. That's the inn. Just mapping out. I don't want to miss anything. That's the prison. Alright, so maybe we'll get permission from the people through here to go in the prison for some reason. I don't know why we'd want to. But if we can, we shall. And that was the map I wanted to hit. Okay. Now, if we go forward, there's a wall, and a wall. What's another way in over here? A little shortcut. Because we have a bit of the wall here that I want to make sure is really still just a wall. And it is. Alright. This was a good surprise, though. I figured there would not be any more towns to see, so it's cool that this is here. Oh, now the ground turns to like a regular dirt color. Oh, it's sand color. Oh, it looks like dirt color. We come a-callin'. Shangri-La Airship Hangar. Oh, is this where our ship is? Does it just automatically go here for some reason? Hangar. Huh. That's the other entrance to there. Oops. I'm assuming there's a door to the hangar. Oh, apparently right there. Well, let's walk around the building, see if there's anything around. Finish mapping. Oh, that's a door. Hangar on Morag. Oh, that's us. I just realized that's us. So this must be our ship. Awesome. Well, we know where our ship is. And there's nothing to see in here, just our ship. Could store things on the ship too, but I think we're okay in that department. Anthony Nutton. That bottle, and there was a spell that I wanted to see if I could memorize. I forget which one it is. Oh, the anti-magic sphere. I must be full of stuff. I should have put Netrak's staff back. Alright. Who had it? I forget. Okay, I'll take one of these. And there's another one that says attack or something. Who has it? Magical attack. I'm gonna go outside and try to learn these. I'll be right back. Okay. I almost forgot too, I want to check out that prison. Dad of Shadows. Beware the shadows. Alright, so I'm gonna save no matter what, but I have the Lich King crown on whatever it's called. Yeah, the Lich crown. So my read magic is unlimited, so I shouldn't fail at all, but just in case. So we gotta go in here. Which scroll do you want to read? I guess we need another one for defense. I guess attack's more important than one of them. How many spell learning points do I have left? 13? That's it? Ugh. Killing me here. If that's more important than the anti-magic. So magical attack, right, is the upgrade for magical weapon, then assault, then attack. Cool. So I got anti-magic sphere as the next one to learn. I don't know if I can learn that. It's funny because I have two of them. I don't have the defense one. That's the one I'd want the most. Tell you the truth. Just double checking. Anti-magic sphere. Duplicate item. Oops. Okay. Yeah, let's see what we have it. So I wonder, did I save? I was thinking about it. Let's see how many spell learning points this takes. Hold on 1 second. Okay. Okay, I've learned that. Oh wait, I just cast it. Didn't I? I just cast it instead. Look at it though. That's pretty awesome. It's like, it was all the way filled out. Alright, well we gotta load, because I wasted that. Oh god, I thought we were out. Alright, it's just one. I want to learn that spell. Now we gotta fight this thing. Speaking of which, let's get the barrier up. Nelvin doing 17 damage on that thing. Wow. Those Morak darts are pretty good. Magical attack. So we'll hit even harder. Points, Nelvin. Look at him go. Wow. Edgel is slicing and dicing. Well, it's gonna get a little easier, maybe. Magic. I want to use the other one. I don't know if we can even memorize it. I thought we were out of the shadow, too. No damage on Edgel. Attack failed. Awesome. Okay, is that far enough out of the shadow? Alright, I want to learn this. Or see if I can. Saving. And then... did not have enough learning points for the spell. Well, actually... hold on 1 second. Right? Anti-magic wall, anti-magic globe. 15 spell learning points for that. Now, as far as... Oh, is that really it? So as far as the defense ones, there's shield, wall, and barrier. So I guess we already have the best defense. And then there's weapon, attack, and assault. But attack is the better one. In this case, I just memorized attack. So they got this screwed up here. And then there's anti-magic wall, which we've been using. Anti-magic globe, which I tried to memorize and couldn't, because we need two more spell learning points. And then there's alchemistic globe, which produces light, increases attack, defense, and anti-magic. We don't have that yet. 250 spell points. I don't know if I can even cast it. Alright. So we can't learn it. That's fine. When she levels up, maybe then. Oh, wow. Well, we're gonna rest anyway. Let's rest. Who's got all the stuff? Okay. At least we can get rations and stuff. Imagine coming out here to this moon and running out of rations. I have a feeling Nelvin's gonna need two, but just in case. Well, I saved some rations by just healing a little bit. Let's see. I can get off 4 small healings. There. Well, she still needs magic, but it eliminates these two at least. She's probably gonna need 2 then. Give that back. And you give that back. Is Nelvin close enough? I'm gonna let him have another ration. Alright, so we've got 1 here, 0, 0, 1. She holds the rest. And 0. So this is the shadow here. So let's get this going. That's not me. Alright, barrier. Attack. And anti-magic wall. Okay. I thought I was getting into a battle. Good. Alright, so I want to check out that prison. I don't know if I can get in trouble for this. That's not the prison. It's over here. Shangri-La Prison. What's this stuff? Suddenly, the sand before you erupts and a mighty lizard leaps toward you. You notice that it has a key on a chain round its neck. Morag lizard. Well, at least we're ready for battle. Failed. Oh, I want to get the LP reading off this thing. Hopefully it doesn't one-shot Walden. 27 damage is going for Walden. 24. It attacks twice. That's not bad. I have a feeling it's just going to have more hit points than the other one. Wait a second. Gotta move that back. Monster LP. Nice, it worked the first time. Burst slide spell. Failed though. Go agile. Wow. He is slaying. Look at that thing. 95 points. Awesome. 83 XP. Cell key. Oh, it was in this pit, huh? Hiding in the pit. I just want to look at these, if there's anything about this. No. Not you. You. Okay. What do we want the cell key for? I mean, what do we want to go in the cell for? I don't know. Trying to make me the leader. Something wore out already. Oh, the anti-magic. That's fine. Anyway, guess we're heading for the next palace? which is... what do we have? Saren. Palace of Saren, or Saren's Palace, or whatever they're calling it. I guess that'll be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys, this huge, extra long episode. See you in the next episode, and always, seek adventure.